Tried and true recipe number 5 is a bad use of a good feature: stacking views. Views are indeed the real relational equivalent of functions in the procedural world, what allows you to reuse queries and share code. But as all good things, views can be abused. They are abused when you create views over views over views, and that you begin querying across a full stack of views. And if you create your views with enough skill, not only many developers will even be totally unaware of what happens at the back, but the optimizer will become unable to detangle the views and perform its work. Here is typically what will happen. You will have a first view built above a number of tables, among which the greenish one. Then you will have a second view built over that same greenish table and a few others. Comes an innocent developer who sees both views and doesn't know how they are built. His query may well need some data that he will get from the view on the left, and some of the data that he will get from the view on the right, using search criteria that exclusively apply to columns from the greenish table. It's easy to understand what happens. Instead of a fairly straight join between three tables that would perform fast, you get a complicated query involving twice the number of tables underneath, in which you do a lot of work to return data that is totally irrelevant to your query and ends up running sluggishly. Now, apply all these recipes, mix and stir, and you get applications that are sure to be popular with your users. The question now is what to do to avoid such a situation. You should get out of your mind that the database is simply the embodiment of an abstract persistence layer. Actually, it's the backbone of most applications. Over the years, I've seen database performance issues sliding from tactical issues, that is, poor indexing or badly written queries, to more strategic issues, such as an abuse of loops and poorly designed programs. All of this resulting from a very light SQL culture among developers. When I say light, I mean they usually know how to spell SQL, which hasn't always been the case, but mostly because of a much better optimization of queries by database products than in the past, and because of an increase in CPU power that still hides many deficiencies. For me, what is critical are principally the design of databases and the architecture of programs. If your building looks like this, it makes little sense to try and fix this. It's for architecture that you must really have gurus. And now, what about developers? Unfortunately, and I am the first to regret it, developers don't look like this. To be fair, they don't look like this either. The truth is that most developers are young and mostly clueless about databases and SQL. These are topics that are hardly taught at the university, and even developers that are very good on other topics can write very poor SQL out of sheer ignorance. Of course, I have nothing against private tuition, particularly if she's pretty. But I must acknowledge that nothing beats mass evangelism. The main issue with SQL is that you can write SQL code, or write SQL code, or write SQL code, or write SQL code, and that mastering SQL, like almost anything, takes time. You must therefore focus on teaching the basics, and the mistakes to avoid. What seems important to me is also to stop thinking that performance problems will be tuned in production. Because if you are serious about performance improvement, most speed issues cannot be instantly solved by DBAs and experts. You must switch from troubleshooting, where the guy who knows is expected to work his magic, to refactoring, where it is admitted that code must be reworked and polished, and that most importantly involves developers, if possible under the guidance of an old hand. Thank you for your attention.